Here's what I do want you to know. We're going to talk a little bit about prospecting and meeting people, all right, in a second. But I want to just kind of get some philosophies. You guys have to understand, number one, all right, what makes this easy is there's something called the BAR system. It stands for belief, activity, results. It's not in your notes. Belief, activity, results. Write that down. Here's what that is. If you don't have the results that you want right now in your business, it's because you don't have the activity necessary to generate those results. And if you don't have the activity, there's something wrong with your belief. Either you don't believe that you can be successful, you don't believe that people can be successful in this business, in this industry, you don't believe in yourself, you don't believe in the product, you don't believe in the opportunity, something lies in the belief. Because I see people all the time that are phenomenal. They got they know everything in the business, but they don't have the same. Look, I don't believe that I'm the smartest person in this business. I really don't. There's people way better than me. There's people that make way more money than me. You know? But here's what's interesting. There's people that know way more about the product than I do, and some of y'all might be sitting in the audience today. All right? But the reason that you're not traveling across the country and you're not at the level that you want to be at in this business is because maybe there's something in the activity that you're not doing. And if someone was looking for me, I can troubleshoot anybody, because if they don't have a lot of activity, I can say, you know what? There's something wrong with their belief. Now let's figure out what that is. Is it the membership? Is it the opportunity? Do you not believe that you can be successful? And here's what I want you to know. Because a lot of this stuff that I teach is like as far as closing and stuff like that, this isn't the type of business where you need to really strong arm close people in the business. It's really not. It's a sorting game. But I do want you to have enough tools to get some of those people over the edge, because you have no idea what can happen to somebody's life if you are that person. Like, listen, I am not mad, Mr. Gregory. All right, when I sat down, I didn't have the money to get involved with the business. But he put the hammer down on me, and he really made me, you know, he made me see the opportunity, you know, in this. Do you have any idea how indebted for my entire life I am to that man? He's like my father now. Thank God he closed me. Thank the Lord that he closed me. Because if he had let me live off of my excuses where, well, you know, I really don't have the money, things are tight, and well, I am just a broke college kid. You know, thank God he didn't give up on me. And I'm trying to let you guys understand that, because you have no idea how many lives you can change with this opportunity if you get serious about it. So you have to know, when you believe that this is the best thing in the world for a person, you will have no problem asking the tough questions. Does that make sense? I want to get your belief to where it needs to be. All right, let's talk about this. In a deck of cards, there's always, out of 52 cards, how many aces are there?
Four.
There's always four aces, and usually a few jokers. All right. So now, here's what this is. In this business, it's a sorting business. If I gave everyone a deck of cards right here, all right, and I said, here's your deck of cards, flip through them, all right, first one to four aces wins. Now, here's what some people do. They'd start flipping cards, and then, you know, they'd pull one over. Now, how much sense would it make if you flipped over a card? Would you guys agree that you're all going to find your aces at different parts in the deck? There's not going to be a person if you shuffle them all up. You know, Mark might get, out of his first 10 cards, four aces. Donnie might go the entire deck, his four aces are at the bottom. But in a deck, how many aces are there?
Four.
Oh, that's right, every time. And then there's those jokers. Look out. They're the ones that'll throw you off the game. Great man, well, that's a scam. I heard about that. My brother's friend's uncle's nephew did that, and he didn't make no money. He lost everything. He lost his house. How much is $26? How do you lose a house? You know? Like, what? There's no overhead in this. You know? But you'll hear the craziest thing. Man, he called up the attorney. The law firm didn't even answer. There wasn't even you'll hear the most ridiculous things. Like, you know, man, you know, it wasn't even the right number. And the guy left town. Yeah? Here's the thing. Never believe any of that stuff. All right? Because it's funny, because I've talked to people that have said stuff to me, and I chase after that story because I want to know the real answer. I say, man, I called my uncle, and he said that he tried to use a membership, and, you know, and he had to pay like $5,000. I'm like, well, what was it? You know, he was a speeding ticket. And I was like, no, speeding ticket's covered. Nuh-uh, he said that he had to pay. So I called up the guy one time, and the guy had a revoked license, All right. He was like had committed some other. There was something else attached. It wasn't a speeding ticket. It was like, you know, it was like a hit and run, and he had no. It was something crazy. And then when I called, I said, "So, sir, you had a speeding because you told one of my associates that you told your nephew that." And he was like, "Oh no, yeah, well, no, it was a speeding ticket too. But what also happened was," I said, "Okay, you know, so don't believe the negative hype. All right, so." In a deck, there's four aces. So here's the deal. If you flip over cards, here's why I say that. Because when I started, my aces were all at the bottom. And I would come to an event, and I'd see someone, their aces were stacked on top. And they come in and like, "Yo, I went manager." "Really? How long you been in?" "52 minutes. Come on. I've been in for 4 months, and I haven't even made my money back. God. You know, and that was way back in the day. But I remember, you know, I was just so frustrated. You know, but you know what's amazing? Those people aren't even in the business today. Mm-hmm. I helped a guy, his first 16 days, he made $2,000. His first 16 days. Came out running. He wanted to start a production company. He had a goal. That's a clue. He said, "I need to make this amount of money so I can buy my video equipment and start my production company." Good friend of mine today. He made $2,000. He got yes, 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 yes. And everyone's like, "Man, this guy's like King Midas. He's got the golden touch." Who is he? He was just a college guy, you know? But you know what ended up happening? He went through about four decks, was like, "Ace, ace, ace, ace. Next deck, ace, 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 ace." And then all of a sudden, he had to go through the other cards. And then he started to get no, 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 no. And he goes, "Man, this doesn't work." I'm like, "Don't work. You had $2,000 in your account. It doesn't work." He's like, something happened. Prepaid legal broke. I said, "No, it's called the numbers game. They're going to catch up to you." All right? So, here's the deal. You don't try and change the cards. Here's what happens. Everyone has their heart set on these people. I know. You got like, "Man, if my sister gets in, oh, she'll kill it. You know, she's like the, you know, whatever, president of this big company." And then she doesn't. But you pulled out a jack and you're over there like trying to erase it and like with a magic marker write ace on it. No, just flip faster. Next. What'd I say? Some won't, so what?
Next.
Just keep going. Because those who you think will won't, and those who you think won't will. When I got recruited, I was sitting on a couch with four other guys or something, three or four other guys. All of them were like in their 40s, you know, and I was like, "Man, I'm not going to get the job." You know, I sat down on the couch and everyone was like older than me and I was like 21 and I was like already intimidated and this guy owned like a restaurant and this guy was this and I was like, "Oh man, dude, he's not going to take me." You know? That's how I thought the business was. I thought I was interviewing. You know, none of them are in the business today. I was the least likely out of everyone to get started and I was the least likely to be successful. Everyone say stick and stay.
Stick and stay.
I think one will. All right. Even when someone says no, they're really saying not now. And what you want to do is you always want to say this little line. Always ask, "Well, look, do you mind if I keep you informed? Do you mind if I keep you?"